Good afternoon, Standard 8 students. Now we are aware of the warning which Banquo had given Macbeth. But the wicked suggestions of the witches had sunk too deep into the mind of Macbeth. Now ever since two of the prophecies had come true, now this had sunk into Macbeth's mind that the third one will also turn out to be true. To allow him to attend to the warnings of the good Banquo, from that time he bent all his thoughts how to compass the throne of Scotland. So he overlooked the good Banquo's advice and warning, and now he bent on, means he made up his mind that anyhow I would want to be the king of Scotland. Now Macbeth had a wife to whom he communicated the strange prediction of the weird sisters and his partial accomplishment. So what Macbeth did was, he had spoken to his wife about this incident, and he told him of how he and Banquo were passing the heaths, and then he came across the three witches, and now two of the three witches, their prophecies had come out to be true. Now the third one is pending, that is to be the king of Scotland. So now Macbeth was already made up his mind that he will follow or look forward for the third prophecy to be true. So she was a bad, ambitious woman, and so as a husband and herself could arrive at greatness, she cared not much by what means. So now Lady Macbeth, she also was a bad and ambitious lady. She also would like to think big. So, and they also wanted to achieve greatness, no matter what foul means they have to use in order to achieve their target. She spurred on the reluctant purpose of Macbeth, who felt compunction at the thought of blood and did not cease to represent the murder of the king as a step absolutely necessary to the fulfillment of the flattering prophecy. Now, according to the conversation both husband and wife had, now they were trying to sort out in which way that the third prophecy could turn out to be true. Then while they were discussing, the wife said that the only way, possible way, for the third prophecy to come true is you have to murder somebody. So Macbeth did not want that to be a part of his accomplishment, because to be the king of Scotland, King Duncan has to die. Okay. And even after the death of King Duncan, if King Duncan dies a natural death, then either of his two sons, one of them will be the king. So, in which way, or which possible way, will Macbeth ever be the king of Scotland? So they were discussing this part of it. And the only way it is possible, it is the downfall or the murder of King Duncan. So, in that respect, Macbeth did not feel comfortable about this part of the story, or this part of how he would be the king of Scotland. So his wife kept on telling him, you have to understand this part, that the murder of King Duncan is very important. Only then you will be able to become the king, for which Macbeth was not actually very pleased with this kind of a decision, and his wife was aware of it. It happened at this time that the king, who out of his royal condescensions would oftentimes visit his principal nobility upon gracious terms, came to Macbeth's house, attended by his two sons, Malcolm and Donalbain, and a numerous train of thanes and attendants, the more to honor Macbeth for the triumphal success of his wars. Now, coincidentally, or it has always been understood that King Duncan, he wanted to honor Macbeth, since Macbeth came back victorious after winning the wars. So King Duncan wanted to honor him. So what he did was, this was his normal behavior with his generals. Whenever his generals would win any kind of battle, King Duncan would go to his house personally. He would leave the throne, leave his palace, and then venture out, go to that person's house with all the lords and all the noblemen, kingsmen, and everyone would go, a huge number would go to the general's house to honor him. And this time it was Macbeth's turn. So King Duncan left his throne, took his two sons, Malcolm and Donalbain, and some of the thanes. Thanes means the lords of certain states, and some of his attendants. He wanted a huge number so that Macbeth will be given a good treat, and plus a lot of people will be there to honor him for his triumphant in war, being victorious. That is a sign of gratitude which King Duncan would want to show to his noblemen or to his generals. The castle of Macbeth was pleasantly situated, and the air about it was sweet and wholesome, which appeared by the nest which the martlet or swallow had built under all the jutting friezes and buttresses of the building, whenever it found a place of advantage. For where those birds most breed and haunt, the air is observed to be delicate. The king entered well pleased with the place, and not less so with the attention and respect of his honored hostess, Lady Macbeth, who had the art of covering treacherous purposes with smiles, and could look like the innocent flower, while she was indeed the serpent under it.